Okay, whenever, whenever, sorry, whatever, the guitar part, you should have in front of you this here scruffily written piece of music. Now, the guitar tab that I've written here, the thing you need to be aware of, the six lines on this tab, the bottom line represents string six. And as you go up, string six, five, four, three, two, one. Strings on the guitar, string six is nearest your head, five, four, three, two, one. So string one is nearest the floor. So string six, along here, nearest the floor, sorry, nearest your head, and string one is nearest the floor. The numbers that you'll see, like four there, two, two, they represent what frets you put your fingers on those particular strings. So I don't know if you can see clearly, but the first note there is going to be on string five, fret four. Second note, string six, fret two, string five, fret two, string five, fret four. Okay. This isn't really a chordy piece, so it's mostly a bit of solo-y picking. Now there is a guitar introduction, down 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 ding 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 type thing. I'm assuming that's going to be played on the keyboard. If you do want to have a look at the guitar tab though, ask me and I can teach you that on guitar, but it's not particularly easy. Have a look at the keyboard music because it is actually written on there. This first section, then the intro, this is after the slow intro, this is where the drums come in. What you've actually got, you can play this with a plectrum or with just your finger, doesn't matter, but for this bit you're actually picking just one note at a time. So with your right hand, now normally I'll be doing my right hand down here, but just for the sake of video, I'll do it here so you can see both hands reasonably clearly. So the first note there, string 5, fret 4. Then, note try not to always use just one finger, because if you do, you always have to look where you're going. Whereas if you use a couple of different fingers, you can leave them in roughly the right position. So I'm using what we call, the fingers go 1, 2, 3, and 4. We obviously don't count the thumb. I'm actually using my third finger on string 5, fret 4. Then, first finger on string 6, fret 2. Then, moving the same one to string 5, fret 2. And then back to string 5, fret 4. And then the introduction finishes with a short note just on string 6, fret 2. So that whole thing, the speed is 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And then it's into the main thing. Watch that bit back again if you need to. Now the verse. If you find this difficult, leave the verse out and just come in the low bit. But what we're actually playing is what we call power chords. So you're always playing two strings, string 6 and string 5, and your fingers are always 2 frets apart. If you have a look at the music on the start of the second line down, you've got string 6, fret 9, and string 5, fret 11. So you can see they're 2 frets apart, and my finger number 3 is on string 5. Now this finger position, you could just move up and down the fretboard. The tricky thing is keeping this distance between them so they don't get too close though, so there'll always be one clear fret between them. So the actual pattern you're doing, the dots on your guitar neck, by the way, should help you here. The dots are on fret 3, 5, 7, 9, and then double dot on 12. So 3, 5, 7, 9, and 12. So it starts off on 9 and 11. That's 7 and 9, sorry. 9, 11 is here. And then that second one moves down to 4 and 6. Just up one fret to 5 and 7. Then we go from 12 and 14 to 7 and 9. The ways to simplify this are, the easiest thing is to leave it out and just come in the chorus, or just play string six. Okay, so you can simplify it, so don't waste too much time trying to get this, but it is a really good, it's a good part if you can do it. So to play that roughly in speed, so I'd go 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4, 4 and 6, 2, 3, 5 and 7, 12 and 14, and 7 and 9. Then you do all that again. Okay, that's that section. The ro-lo-lo-lo-lo-lo bit. There are two ways you could do this, and you can see on the music. One sec. I've got, this is the way I did it originally, which is doing the same stuff using these power chords, so 2 and 4, etc. But then I did an alternative version, which, to be honest, sounds better. First of all, I'll do this original version up here, the power chord version, and that's quite simply, so it's 2 and 4, do 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 do, 9 and 11. Do, 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 do. Then 5 and 7, and then 7 and 9. Okay, do that again. So it's 2 and 4. Do, 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 do. 9 and 11. Do, 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 do. 5 and 7. Ba bam, ba bam, ba bam. Then 7 and 9. Before you go into the chorus, the other way that I think sounds better is at the bottom of your sheet there, and that sounds like this. So the notes you've actually got, string 6, fret 2, then quite quickly, same string, fret 4, open string 5, to string 5, fret 4, so that first bit, 2, 3, listen again, so it's fret 2, 2, 3. Then carry on, string 4, fret 2, then string 5, fret 2, 2, 3, 4, then the same note again. Sorry, missed it. Same note again. So listen to that bit a couple of times. So it goes 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3. Listen again. 2, 3. 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4. That bit is actually played during that section, so if you listen carefully to the original, you should be able to hear that. Then you're on to the chorus. Chorus, a bit more picking, nice and simple, two beats on each. So it starts with on string 5, fret 4, then open, string 4, fret 2, then string 5, fret 2. String 5, fret 4, string 5, open, string 6, fret 2, and string 5, fret 2. So that chorus all the way through goes 2, 3, 4. Or however it goes. Now that, I think, repeats once or twice, but by listening to it, you can work that out. So each section on that is two beats each. So it's 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. And that's the guitar bit. Do look at each section, just one section at a time, and you should be able to make sense of it. And obviously watch any sections of this video clip back again.